Morning students, I am Surbhi Jain and today we will discuss the chapter number 10. Its name is Time and Temperature. So in this chapter, we already discussed half of the chapter and we did some questions of this exercise to learn page number 175. So its third question is, Sahil was born on 13th of August 2014. So we have to find that how old was he on 24th of November 2014. So when Sahil was born on 13th of August 2014. We have to find age of Sahil on 24th of November 2014. So, as we discussed in previous questions, that when we have to find the time duration between months, we conclude it month wise. Okay, so in that question, firstly we take month of August. So in August, it is starting from 13th of August. So we take 13th August to 31st August, because there are 31 days in month of August. Then after August it is September. So first September to 30 September. Then first October to 31st October. And first November 24th of November. So we have to find the age of Sahil on 24th of November. Then how many days are there from 13th of August to 31st of September? 31st of August. There are 19 days are there. And 1st September to 30 September, there are 30 days. Same as there are 31 days. And here, this is 24 days. Then, total days are 9 and 10 and 4, 14, carry 1, 3 1 4 and 3, 7 to 9 and 1, 10. So how old was Sahil? Sahil was 104 days old on 24th of November 2014. This is our answer. So our next question is question number 4. Jaya watched a TV program from 6:45 p.m. to 8:15 p.m. 17 minutes were used up in viewing two advertisements. What was the duration of the TV program? So in that question, time duration of Jaya's program. The time duration in between 8:15 p.m. and 6:45 p.m. Then how will we find that time duration? we subtract 645 from 850 because both the units are in PM, so we don't need because both the units are in PM. So we subtract 645 from 850 and we have to borrow 1 hour from this 8. So it is 7. This is 15 plus 60 because we borrowed 1 hour from 8, and this is as same 645. So this is 775 and 645. Then we subtracted 5 minus 5, 0, 7 minus 4, 30, and 6 minus 4, 1. So the time duration of Jaya's program is 1 hour and 30 minutes, but it is given that 17 minutes were used up in viewing 2 advertisements. So we subtract 17 minutes from this time interval. Then 130 minus 17. So we got 130. So the time duration of Jaya's program is 1 hour and 30 minutes. Our next question is question number 5, in which Mohit went on a tour to Bangalore. He started on 13th of January 2018 and returned on 9th of February 2018. So how long was his tour? Then we have to find the time duration between 13th of January 2018 and 9th of February 2018. So how do we find out? Firstly, Mohit started his journey on 13th of January 2018 and February 2018. So what is the time difference between 13th of January and 9th? You can say time duration of Mohit's tour is 26 days. So from 13th of January to 31st of January 2018, there are 18 days, and from 1st February to 9th February there are 9 days. So total number of days are 27 days. Then time duration of Mohit's tour is of 27 days. This is your answer. So our next topic is temperature. What is temperature? Temperature is a measure of how hot or cold a place or an object is. Okay, so for measurement of temperature, we used a device which is called thermometer. Thermometer is used to measure that temperature. Okay. and there are different scales of temperature by which we measure how much the temperature is. So first one is Celsius scale, and second one is Fahrenheit scale, and third one is Kelvin scale. But in your syllabus there are only two types of scale, and these are majorly used in our daily life. Like first one is Kelvin scale and second one is Fahrenheit scale. So there are two types of scale for measuring temperature. First is Celsius scale and second one is Fahrenheit scale. And freezing point of water in Celsius scale is 0 degree Celsius, and boiling point of water in Celsius scale is 100 degree Celsius. Same as in Fahrenheit scale, freezing point of water is 32 degree Fahrenheit and boiling point of water is 212 degree Fahrenheit. So when we equate that freezing point and boiling point, we can say that 0 degree Celsius is equal to 32 degree Fahrenheit and 100 degree Celsius is equal to 212 degree Fahrenheit. So the next one is how to convert the temperature. When we have to find conversion of temperature, we take different scale, and to convert from Fahrenheit to Celsius, there is a formula in which degree Celsius is equal to degree Fahrenheit minus 32 and whole multiply of 5 by 9. As same as when we convert from Celsius scale to Fahrenheit scale, we took the formula degree Fahrenheit is equal to degree Celsius into 9 by 5 and the bracket of whole plus 32. Let's do some question based on conversion of temperature. So the first question is, temperature of a hot glass of milk is 70 degree Celsius. Convert the temperature into Fahrenheit scale. So temperature in Celsius scale is equal to 70 degree Celsius, and temperature we have to find the temperature into Fahrenheit scale. So what is the formula? Degree Fahrenheit is equal to degree Celsius, which is 70 degree Celsius, multiply 9 by 5 plus 30. So when we multiply it, 900 97 63 divided by 5 and plus 2. Then we divide that 630 by 5. So 5 is the 5. 6 minus 5, 1. Then this 3 comes here. 5 to the 10. 1 minus 1, 0. And that 3. And that 0 comes here. So 5, 6 to 30. This is 126. And we add that 32 in it. So what is the sum is 6 to 8, 3 to 5 and 1. So it is 158 degree Fahrenheit, and that is our answer. In the next question, we have to convert from Fahrenheit to Celsius. So we have to convert 122 degree Fahrenheit into Celsius scale. Then formula of finding Celsius is equal to Fahrenheit, so this is 122 in Fahrenheit minus 32 multiply 5 by 9. So 122 minus 32 is equal to 90, then 5 by 9. So So 9 times the 90 and 10 times the 50. So the answer is 50 degrees Celsius.
So it's over for today. And thank you, class. Thank you so much.